Welcome to the Director's Chair with Kyle. Today, we are talking about one of my favorites, Stanley Kubrick. Stanley Kubrick was born on July 26, 1928, in New York City. He began work as a photographer when his father gave him a camera at the age of 13. He made a few documentaries and scrapped together enough money to film his first film, Fear and Desire, in 1953.
Waiting.
He then moved on to The Killer's Kiss in 1955, and The Killing in 1956. In 1960, Kubrick caught everyone's attention in his next film, Spartacus. This film won 4 Oscars, although none of them went to Kubrick himself. In 1963, Kubrick directed Loyota, which became quite controversial. In 1964, Kubrick directed one of my personal favorites, Dr. Strangelove, or How I Learned to Stop Worrying and Love the Bomb. It was a big risk for Kubrick. Before this, nuclear war was not considered a subject for comedy. Originally written as a drama, Kubrick decided that too many of the ideas he had written were just too funny to be taken seriously. The film's critical and commercial success allowed Kubrick the financial and artistic freedom to work on any project he desired. With that freedom, Kubrick created what is known to be one of the greatest sci-fi films of all time, 2001: A Space Odyssey. Made in 1968, this film was a trailblazer in terms of special effects and cinematography, and gave Kubrick an Academy Award for Best Special Effects, the only Oscar he ever received. In 1971, Kubrick released A Clockwork Orange, a film that caused controversy for its sex and violence. In 1975, Kubrick directed Barry Lyndon, which gave him the reputation of being difficult with actors. Dozens and dozens of takes were given, with no breaks for the actors. In 1980, Kubrick took a shot at horror and created The Shining, based off of a Stephen King novel. The film was a commercial and critical success, yet Stephen King himself didn't like it and decided to remake it in 1997. That happened. Just ignore that, please. As his career began winding down, Kubrick directed Full Metal Jacket, a realistic war film set in Vietnam. This too became an instant classic. Kubrick released his last film in 1999, Eyes Wide Shut. It had mixed reviews, but Kubrick claimed it was his best work yet. Kubrick died tragically in his sleep on March 7, 1999 of a heart attack. Kubrick's style is one that has inspired many directors, from Wes Anderson to George Lucas. His cinematography used one-point perspective and tracking shots to create a symmetrical, almost surreal image like in these clips shown here. Kubrick also became famous for harvesting actors' performances by using a zoom. He used a zoom to display important information or to express the character's feelings to the audience. Kubrick was also a trailblazer for special effects. 2001 is unreal. Look at that. Just look at that. It's amazing. But seriously, Kubrick's work inspired many and set a new standard for effects in film. Stanley Kubrick is one of the greatest directors of all time because he is so versatile. He displayed common themes throughout all genres, including war, horror, love, comedy, and sci-fi. His work was always very grand in scope, tackling big subjects, but it also managed to steer away from cliches. Kubrick broke the rules. A lot. He wasn't exactly politically correct.
Private Pyle, why is your footlocker unlocked?
Sir, I don't know, sir!
Private Pyle, if there is one thing in this world that I hate, it is an unlocked footlocker! You know that, don't you?
Sir, yes, sir!
If it wasn't for dickheads like you, there wouldn't be any thievery in this world, would there?
Sir, no, sir!
Get
the picture. It's awesome. Kubrick's main theme throughout his whole filmography would be dehumanization. He wanted to break down what made each of his characters human. He displays the dark side of human nature and the harsh environment they live in, conquering reason and manipulating man's psychological makeup to the point of crushing creativity, compassion, and individualism. Dark stuff, I know. But this is what made Kubrick so great. He made risky films. Films that pushed the envelope. Whether it was evolution, the Vietnam War, or just some really, really, really messed up dudes, Kubrick had it all. He was one of the greatest film directors of all time, and his work will be remembered forever.
And we fucked around for an hour and 20 minutes.
No, they all got changed. Then we had, I mean, I know it seems like a lot of tea breaks, but we had the tea break that was up over there. We had that when he did his knee.
You mean you had a tea break at 4 o'clock? And no, you have a tea break at 6 o'clock?
No, this is a fresh tea break. He came up to me for the tea here.
No, but if you had a tea break at 4, you don't have to break for this tea break.